reason I sit is because I have a severe case of arthritis in my back, and it causes me a lot of pain if I stand or if I walk for very long. So, yeah, morning. I will be having a treatment called radio frequency ablation, hopefully next month. And this is Tom. Good morning. I just thought I should explain why I'm sitting. Did you catch that, Tom? I'm sitting because I have a severe case of arthritis in my back. Thank you. Doctor said it was the worst he'd ever seen. Yeah, well, he's also young, but relatively speaking, you know. Well, get this treatment done. Yes. The treatment hopefully will take care of it for 6 months to a year. So there we go. All right, let us worship God. Though there are rulers, presidents, kings, queens, God is the Lord of all life. In God we live and move and have our being. God requires our faithfulness and our service. We reach out to others with the same kind of love with which God has touched our lives. Come, let us worship the Lord who is always with us. Let us praise God who daily walks by our side. Amen. Let us now prepare to come into the presence of God by taking a moment of silence so that we may make our own individual confessions. Let us pray. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Anyone who stands with Christ and is born again is a new creation. The old life is gone. A new life has begun. Know that you are forgiven and be at peace. Thanks be to God. Amen. It is now our time to turn to God in prayer. And let me just advise you that we will be including the Lord's Prayer during our communion service, so we will not be praying it during this part of our worship today. I would ask what your prayer request might be. Anyone? All right. And then let us turn to God in prayer. Gracious and loving God, you are an amazing God, and we are so blessed to be called your children. We are grateful, God, that you did not turn away our ancestors, Adam and Eve, when they committed the first sin by eating of the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Indeed, not only did you not kill them, but you saved them. Yes, they were exiled, but exiled to a different kind of life, a life in which they created more human beings, and yet more humans were created, and we learned how to be faithful to you, O God. We thank you for your prophets, who through their words taught us to be faithful to you. We especially thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who through his life, death, and resurrection gave us a special knowledge of your love. We thank you, God, for this creation that you have made, the earth and all that is in it, for the trees and the flowers and the bushes, for the birds and the animals and the fish, for the humans, grows on the earth and all that runs on the earth and all that flies over the earth and all that swims in the seas. We thank you, God, for your creation. We thank you for the people of this world, O God, for the different countries which make up your world and make up people who express their faithfulness in different languages and in different ways, but are still your beloved children. And on this World Communion Sunday, O God, we are especially grateful for the differences that you have created in us and made us more accepting of you and of your children. We pray, O God, for all your children, and we pray for your church. We certainly pray for this congregation, the Korean Presbyterian Church here in Pinellas Park, for all of the people who serve you through this congregation, for Pastor Kim, for all those who are faithful here. And we pray for the Presbyterian Church USA and for all churches around the world, that all of us may work together, O God, to serve you, to share your love, and to help your people know that they are loved. These things we pray, O God, in Christ's holy name. Amen. Our scripture lesson today is from the prophet Jeremiah in the Old Testament, reading chapter 18, verses 1 through 11. This is the New Revised Standard Version. Listen to this reading of God's holy word. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord: "Come, go down to the potter's house, and there I will let you hear my words." So I went down to the potter's house, and there he was, working at his wheel. The vessel he was making of clay was spoiled in the potter's hand, and he reworked it into another vessel, as seemed good to him. Then the word of the Lord came to me: "Can I not do with you, O house of Israel, just as this potter has done, says the Lord? Just like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. At one moment I may declare concerning a nation or a kingdom that I will pluck up and break down and destroy it. But if that nation concerning which I have spoken turns from its evil, I will change my mind about the disaster that I intended to bring on it. And at another moment I may declare concerning a nation or a kingdom that I will build and plant it. But if it does evil in my sight, not listening to my voice, then I will change my mind about the good that I had intended to do to it. Now, therefore, say to the people of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem, thus says the Lord, look, I am a potter shaping evil against you and devising a plan against you. Turn now, all of you, from your evil ways and amend your ways and your doings." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Pots and feet of clay. Some years ago, I fulfilled a lifelong dream and took a class in pottery making. I had always wanted to learn to throw pots on a wheel. You've probably seen people doing it, either in person or maybe on a video. They sit at the wheel, throw a lump of clay on the wheel, and begin spinning it with a foot pedal. As they form the malleable clay into the desired object, periodically they spray a little water on it to keep the clay workable. The first day of class,